of Domination. We have confirmation. We understand that Stone Cold Steve Austin did indeed stun the man they call Vader.
With a 20-minute time limit. Making their way to the ring, being accompanied by Nation of Domination member Kama. At a combined weight of 575 pounds, D'Lo and the World Wrestling Federation Intercontinental Champion, The Rock, Rookie My Via.
Getting set for tag team action featuring The Rock and D'Lo Brown from the Nation of Domination. They'll be taking on Ken Shamrock and Mark Henry. Let's take it back to 2 weeks ago on Shotgun Saturday Night. Mark Henry one-on-one against D'Lo Brown. And Mark Henry, with the application of the bear hug, had this match won until Kama came in and interfered. From there, the Nation struck with tremendous ferocity on the world's strongest man. Eventually, it was a four-on-one situation. Farooq with the lashings, Kama and The Rock stomping away on the former Olympian until Ken Shamrock came down and saved Mark Henry. And Shamrock cleaned house. And you gotta know, with Shamrock's mind focus on The Rock, this tag team contest is gonna be hot right here on Raw.
Shamrock may be the future of the WWF. His future is this Sunday on pay-per-view. Are we looking at the next Intercontinental Champion, Shamrock, Maya Villa, one-on-one? What a matchup! It's this Sunday for Intercontinental Gold at the Royal Rumble.
Missing the big top. If they are, they made a shirt for Mark Henry. 415 pounds, a 64-inch chest. He is the world's strongest man with a...
Now, before The Rock addresses your ignorance for wearing the Rocky Sucks t-shirt, let me share something with all The Rock's fans. You know, last week, the Pittsburgh Steeler quarterback Cordell Stewart called The Rock, and he said, "Rock, what do I got to do to go to the Super Bowl and become a champion?" Well, hell, before The Rock could call Cordell back, he went and called that old goat Joe Paterno, and he got advice from him. And now, look, neither one of them are champions like The Rock. Now, you managed to do something, Mark Henry, you shouldn't have done, and that's pissed The Rock off. You're actually ignorant enough to go out and buy one of those Rocky Sucks t-shirts. But I'll tell you what, The Rock guarantees tonight, in front of all of his fans, that I'm gonna rip that shirt right off your fat, ugly ass. And Ken Shamrock, if you got any manhood to you, you'll stay in here and get a piece of The Rock.
So the self-proclaimed people's champion, the Intercontinental Champion, The Rock, along with D'Lo Brown to take on Mark Henry and Ken Shamrock, we're going to start things off now with a preview of Sunday's Intercontinental title matchup, The Rock and Ken Shamrock. Shamrock now, right hand, going to work on The Rock. I have to believe, JR, Shamrock will be the next Intercontinental Champion right here in the WWF.
Well, Shamrock is not thinking about the title right now. He's thinking about revenge on Maya Villa. You do not want Shamrock to snap. The former king of the Ultimate Fighting world can be as bad as anybody who's ever stepped in the squared circle.
The Rock now hammering away with a big right hand, and Shamrock goes down. Not to take anything away, though, from The Rock, a blue-chip athlete. And here comes one of the most underrated athletes in the WWF, D'Lo Brown. But Shamrock goes to work now on D'Lo.
Pounding away on the former football team member from the University of Maine, a Maine Black Bear, graduated with his degree in accounting, but just got schooled in a knee drop there from the world's most dangerous man.
All four of these men in this tag team matchup will compete in the Royal Rumble match this Sunday on pay-per-view.
But JR, with it being every man for himself, certainly you've got to wonder what happens if Kama and D'Lo, say, are paired off against one another.
The Rock from behind to D'Lo follows with a clothesline. The Rock directing traffic now, and he comes back into the ring to go to work on the world's most dangerous man, Ken Shamrock.
Rock is going to look to seize upon this opportunity, looking to gain some momentum heading into Sunday.
Ooh, the Rock with a power move, shoulder breaker. Shamrock in trouble, really needs to make a tag here.
Rock surprisingly deliberate.
There it is, the big elbow across the sternum. The Rock going to go for a cover, hooks the leg. There's two, and Shamrock gets the left shoulder up.
Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, still to come, we're going to find out about the negotiations of the baddest man on the planet, Mike Tyson, to participate in WrestleMania 14. But are the rumors true? Will Mike Tyson be in San Jose Sunday for the Royal Rumble? Plus, DX has a major announcement, apparently, concerning the Undertaker's family.
Here's a cover by Shamrock, almost three.
And will this be the night that 29 WWF superstars eliminate Stone Cold Steve Austin from even competing in Sunday's Royal Rumble?
Rocky missed with the right hand, Shamrock.
As if last week was not bad enough, Stone Cold has continued the stunner barrage, so far getting the Godwins and Vader tonight.
Shamrock is walking tall.
Look out, big. Belly to belly. This could be it.
Ankle lock submission coming up here.
Shamrock setting up the Rock for the ankle lock submission hold. What is this?
What? Mark Henry.
Mark, what the hell is he doing?
Henry just floored Ken Shamrock.
Mark Henry has attacked his own partner. And a and 15-pound power slam. Good Lord. Shamrock can be broken in half. Oh, and what an elbow. Right to the heart. And The Rock just told Mark Henry one more time. The former U.S. Olympian has absolutely... Oh, this is disgusting.
I cannot believe what I'm seeing. The world's strongest man turned his back on his partner, Ken Shamrock.
No doubt, Rocky Maivia does not want to meet Shamrock. With Shamrock at 100%. Sunday at the Rumble, the Intercontinental title. And look, all that Rock's got him covered. And Mark Henry executing the three count. Big deal. Shamrock has been busted apart by the Nation and Mark Henry. And Mark,
well, the Rock ripped off the t-shirt like you said he was going to.
I don't believe this.
Henry with a Nation of Domination t-shirt.
You can debate whether or not Rocky Maivia sucks. I'll tell you what sucks right now.
Mark Henry embracing the Nation of Domination.
This has got to be a shock to Mark Henry's his advisor, Terry Todd, down in Austin, Texas, the United States Olympic Committee. Everybody that's helped Mark Henry all his life. The people in Silsbee, Texas, have got to be just sick at their stomach right now.
What about me? What about us sitting here in State College, PA, and all the shock fans?
There's Farooq,
presenting the newest member, I guess.
Member of the Nation, as we take you back to Michael Cole.
The Nation of Domination, The Rock. What happened?
Oh, shut up. I'm going to tell you exactly what happened. Hey, this is the greatest day in the history of the Nation. Well, actually, the greatest day was when The Rock joined. But at the same time, God, man, I did this all for you, Farooq. Hey, whoa. Know your role. Farooq, man, I'm telling you, this is the greatest thing since sliced bread. Not only did The Rock bring intercontinental gold to the Nation, but I've got the world's strongest man, Mark Henry, now in the Nation. God, man, it's all for you. Hell.
Folks, that's it for Raw tonight. Coming up next in the War Zone in 30 seconds, Sean, Triple H, and China. DX will be here.